Hello Pirates, this is Yun for the Hunnatives of the Plunder Pirates. In this video, we're going to find out about the defense strategy called the funnel layout that I have invented. Let's try to find out what's the pros and cons and check it out on the video. When you play the Plunder Pirates, you must have this kind of experience that other multiplayers going to try to attack you, putting their troops as much as wide as possible and spreading them out to minimize the damage caused by the mortar. So I was thinking, is there any layout that can block this kind of formation of attackers? So I tried to experiment and I'll show you from this following video. This was my first experiment, so I named it funnel type because it looks like a funnel, like a strait. So you can see this in video that this kind of a funnel layout, it will block the troops being deployed in a spreaded layout. So you can see that the gunners are now deployed at this one point. Bang! The mortar just hits all the gunners. And with this second shot of the mortar, you can see in this slow video, bam, did you see that? The whole gunners are just massacred. So when you see at the north side, you can see that like more than 20 gunners are now being deployed in that strait, that funnel. Just try to imagine this mortar has hit that spot. With like only two shots, like 20 gunners can be killed in one shot. But as you can see, I'm in the level 377, so that's why I'm being attacked by two strong guys. So try to maintain your level ranking about in 150s. Anyway, so I thought this layer was too weak, so I tried to put some kind of protection layer outside the fence. So this is kind of a revised strat layout that I've been doing. And let's try to find out what's the difference from the previous layout. But for this layout, what I missed was that, yes, I had the protection layer outside the fence, but the thing was that it was outranged with the defense. So what happened was this, only 6 gunners, all my protection layer has been destroyed. And now I already have like about more than 40% of damage already. So yes, you have to protect that for sure. So this was my experiment 3. So the protection layer with the protection. On this revised layout, you can see that now the bunkers now will be protecting this protection layer and the funnels, the straits. And symmetrically on the other side, it's going to be in the same layout that this bunker will be covering this side also. On the south, if the troops enemy attack from this side, the ship will be protecting this this other side. And if the troops come from the north side, you can see that it's been fortified with 7 cannons in that side, so it's not going to be easy to attack from the north side also. The reason why there's a lot of cannons at the north side is because when you have a lot of experience at the game, you will easily find out that people will try to attack from the building sides instead of the ship sides, because if there's a ship, like always, the troops always detour and try to walk all the way around, and it's gonna take a long time. As you can see in this video, the enemy is attacking from the north side as we expected. So in this case, try to put the pirate hull at the north side, because the pirate hull is the strongest building in this game. So what it does is that it's gonna be really a good bait, and it's gonna save a lot of time, and it's gonna save some time for their defense systems to shoot more, and it's gonna put more damage to the enemy's troops before they come near their base. Oh, the power hall is a very, very good bait, but if you're very interested in the rankings, try not to put the power hall in the north side, because like this, you can see there's only the 3 gunners gonna be attacking the power hall, and it's gonna end you up in the defeat. So the choice is yours. Let's see the rankings. That if the power hull is tore down, anyway, it's gonna end you up in the defeat. So when you look at this defense log, so you can see that it's 17% damage only, but I have been defeated. So that's how it ends up when you put a power hull in the north side. Okay, now let's try to wrap up today's conclusion about the funnel layout. As I said before, if you're interested in the rankings, try to put and protect your pirate hull inside the fence and near the ship side at the bottom right here. Instead of the pirate hull, you can put the academy, which is also a strong building. And near the academy, try to put the tavern, which is also strong, and those masonries near there. So it's going to save some time for the cannons before they come to your near the base. place the protection layer at the outside of the fence and put the storage inside the fence. And put the mortar, which is the most important defense system, and put a lot of cannons at the north side. As I said, people will attack from the building side instead of the ship side. So at the south, put the voodoo hut and the guild hall next to each other. So they're going to be straight at the middle, and it's going to be protected by the ship. Thank you for watching, and this was about the funnel layout, the defense strategy. So for the more layout strategies to come, please subscribe in YouTube. Thanks for watching.